You're watching Dibber.
My name's Brian's brother, Brian, and you're watching Dibber. Yeah.
Hi there, folks, and welcome to this week's episode of
Mad Monday.
Yes, Mad Monday again. Right, firstly, I would like to send a big thank you to 10Phoenix01. There'll be a link to his channel down there for today's intro. I'd like you guys and girls to go and check him out, especially. If you like what he's doing over there, please subscribe to him. But the reason I'd like to give him a shout today is because he is covering a very controversial story that has broken here in the UK. That's all I'm going to say about that. Go across to his channel and you'll see exactly what I'm talking about, yeah? It's very controversial. And he makes some very, very strong points in it, yeah? Absolutely, that's a brilliant video, fella. Right, as you can see, I've got a slightly different background today. So firstly, I'd like to send a big shout out today to Sally's Handbag, who's featured me on his YouTube channel. Hey, cheers, fella. Right, also, I'd like to send a shout out to Auntie Alfie. A little bit too late for me to get him up on the background, but he gave me another big shout himself today on his YouTube channel. Thank you very much, fella. Right, who else have we got there? The West Aussie, who gave me another big feature featuring this channel. Big thumbs up to you as well, fella. And the other person that you can see on there is El Gatto. He's got me featured on his main YouTube channel this week. You are a diamond geezer. And last but no means least, this is a guy I've wanted to give a little mention to for quite some time, and that is the Weird Fat Bloke. He is absolutely fantastic, and he makes a really nice variety of videos on his channel. All of those links are down there in the Brit Bar. Right, now let's get on with today's story. Today's story is about the blowing up, the destruction of parking meters. You know those ones that you have to put money in to get a little ticket to put in your car, display in your car to show that you've paid to park? Well, it would seem that in Sussex, a little terrorist group has decided to strike, yeah? And they're kind of pissed off with the way that the local council are conducting their ways of trying to control, parking and traffic in their town. And basically what they've done is they've resorted to go around and blowing up, literally blowing up the machines where you get your tickets from. Now, I know that I just chuckled at that because, the idea of blowing up parking meters, it appeals to me. But then there's a real danger side to it, because this could actually hurt people. And when you actually look at the reality of it, it is actually a form of domestic terrorism, yeah? It is an act of terrorism, an act of vandalism. It also puts a great financial strain on the local authorities. But in saying that, yeah? We in the UK, I don't know about, anywhere else in the world, but our councils and our governments are trying to basically hit us with different types of stealth tax, yeah? And this is another way of hitting us with stealth tax. Basically, what they've done is they've taken, a local problem, yeah? And they're trying to rectify it by making people pay more money. And that is a stealth tax. The simplest solution, and I know some of you probably won't agree with that, is just don't have so many cars on the road. It is that simple. Now then, I can say, for instance, and I have spoken to this fella about it because he has actually got issues with this himself and has actually said to his kids, look, you're going to have to find yourself somewhere private to park. You're going to have to get yourselves garages because you are causing a problem outside in the street. Now, basically, what we've got here, we've got a scenario where you've got the husband who owns a car, who happens to be like my mate. His wife has got a car. Now, outside their house, they park one car and one goes on the drive. They've got enough room to do it. But they've got four kids. All of them have got cars. Yeah? So you've got six cars in one household. Yeah? The guy next door to him, yeah, he's got a car. He's also got a Land Rover, his wife's got a car, and he's got five kids living with him still at his house that are all grown up, because obviously over in the UK it's pretty hard to get a council house now, right? They've all got cars. So just those two families alone have taken up pretty much half the parking for that street. And that is the scenario that we're facing here in the UK. Too many cars on the road. Now then, like I say, I did chuckle at the story about them blowing up the parking meters. But, you know, myself, you know, many a time I've wanted to blow up a parking meter or go and tear down a speed camera or, you know, hang a tyre over it, put some petrol in, etc. You know, we've all had those thoughts. But there is the danger and the moral aspect of this, because it actually puts a big strain on the local council resources, which then gets passed on to the local community because they have to reap that money back. Anyway, I'd like to know what your thoughts are on this today, right? If you knew that you could get away with blowing up a parking meter and nobody was going to get injured at all, yeah? Would you do it? Of course I'd bloody do it. Leave your comments down there. Be greatly interested to hear about this one. What was that? Yeah, I know. There's lots of ways you can make explosives. You'll stay safe. All the links to the channels I've featured are down there in the Brit Bar today. I'm off to blow up a parking meter. Bye now.